Welcome back and thanks for tuning into our tutorial on creating accessible Excel documents. This video is for all APS employees creating documents for posting on the web or distributing across the district. We'll be going through the steps needed to create and correct Excel documents with web accessibility in mind. So, where should we start? What kind of errors are we talking about? Well, let's take a look. The first step to creating an accessible Excel document is to open the Accessibility Checker. Microsoft has a great tool built right in to help you find and correct accessibility errors. If you're using Office 365 or Excel 2016 for Mac, you'll find it here under the Review tab. If you're using Excel on a Windows machine, or if you're using an older version of Excel, you'll find it by checking on File, Info, Check for Issues, Check Accessibility. The tool will highlight and show you how to fix any of the accessibility errors in your document or spreadsheet. Sheet names in an Excel file must be unique, providing information about what can be found in it. Using brief descriptive names and not leaving any blank or unnamed sheets make it easier for people using assistive technologies to navigate. To rename a sheet, right-click on the Sheet tab and select Rename. Type a brief, unique name that is descriptive of the sheet contents. To delete a sheet, right-click the Sheet tab and then select Delete. It is important to specify column header information in your spreadsheets because screen readers use this information to identify rows and columns. To add headers to an existing table, position the cursor anywhere in the table. On the Table tab, select the Header Row checkbox and type in your column headings. To add headers to a new table, first select the cells you want to include in the table. On the Insert tab, select Table and select the My Table Has Headers checkbox. Select OK and then type new descriptive names at the top of each column in the table. Screen readers keep track of their location in a table by counting the table cells, so you'll want to keep your table structure as simple as possible. If a table is nested within another table, or if a cell is merged or split, the screen reader can lose count and won't be able to provide accurate information. Additionally, cells that have been merged or split can throw off the reading order and affect the way a screen reader is going to move from cell to cell. Unmerging cells won't change the look of the spreadsheet, but will read aloud the entire cell as one, allowing for an uninterrupted flow. To unmerge cells, select the cell and click on the Home tab. Activate the Merge and Center drop-down list and choose Unmerge Cells. To delete a blank cell or row, first highlight the cell or row, then right-click and select Delete. Deleting blank cells is super helpful for someone using a screen reader so they don't think they have reached the end of the table. Spreadsheets can be considered as a giant table, but you can also create one inside the spreadsheet. If any errors pop up after running the Accessibility Checker, you can add alt text to it by right-clicking anywhere on it. A menu will then open and select Table, Alternative Text. Include the most important information in the title box, two or three words will do. The title is what the screen reader will see first. It will most likely require a description. Go ahead and add something about the formatting and some details. Some other things that we need to think about when working on documents are adding alternative text and using meaningful hyperlink text. We've covered these topics in the Accessible Word Documents video, but just wanted to give them an honorable mention here because many people add graphics and links to their spreadsheets. Being that not all Excel spreadsheets are just rows and columns of textual data, often including charts and pictures to add some flair, it's important to include a title or brief description for each. As always, you'll want to avoid using link text such as click here or read more. Users will not understand what that link leads to. Instead, use a link that gives readers an actual description of the link destination. An easy way to check is to see if the link text would make sense when read by itself. Once you're done, save your file and give yourself a hearty pat on the back. You should be proud of yourself. We sure are. You've just created an accessible document that the federal government would be impressed with. Just a note, before you leave and run to apply what you've learned, Excel does not save accessibility changes when saved as a PDF. As a result, you would need to repair the PDF in Adobe Acrobat Pro. An acceptable workaround would be to save a locked version of the Excel spreadsheet and a PDF one if you like. Thanks for tuning in and doing your part in helping APS set the standard for accessible web content. Together, we'll make sure that our web content is available to everyone.